that we have accepted and we acknowledge the request, and we will meet with Director McCabe next week to discuss when and the procedure and what we're going to do. So we would like to meet with you sometime next week at your convenience.
Thank you.
Okay. And I appreciate you taking care of this for this meeting. Thank you. It's good to have it on the agenda, always. Okay, I want to go back now to the letter from Mr. Jim Cran.
Well, you know, as far as replying to this, a lot of this has been explained in the newspaper. Mm-hmm. Some of it's self-evident. I mean, we don't have enough equipment, nothing to do about that. Right. And the legislature has to change that. So, you know, I think it's a waste of our time to respond to this letter.
Is that a motion?
What do you think?
Well, he says that one of the problems was security of absentee ballots in the aftermath of the election. There was no problem with security of the absentee ballots in the after the election. And that's the part I resent the most. Yes, there were problems with lines and we didn't have enough equipment. We acknowledge that. But I think we definitely need to let him know that absentee ballots were never lost. They were always secured, and we knew there were more. And when we did an overall count, it matched perfectly with the number that the county clerk's office transferred to us. Mm-hmm. There was never a question of security of absentee ballots, right. And that part bothers me.
There's one other thing in here that I want to comment on that I forgot about until I just looked at this, and that is in the third paragraph. It says, poorly trained poll officials. I kind of resent that piece a little bit because, A, he's never attended the poll for the training, mm-hmm. and everybody gets 2 hours of mandatory training. Whether they've all absorbed it at the same level is really the issue, and that's something that's hard for us to control. But that's going to make it hard for us to recruit new poll workers, because if they're going to be attacked by local so-called business leaders, I think that's a mistake.